Once again, welcome to the business show. Now, there's been so much happening through the week in the world of business. And the most one that stood out was in the area of farming. Of course, we know for a fact that there was a shortage as well. But let's talk about farming this week, because a whole delegation was down here in Kampala, actually, to be more specific, Speak Resort Munyonyo, to discuss how to encourage more farmers across the East African region to use fertilizers to boost food production. Now, with the skyrocketing food prices, the experts are concerned that if farmers don't utilize fertilizers that should be able to help them increase on the production or productivity from their different gardens, then we could be set for food shortage in the near future. This week on Views from the Top, we speak to the president of the Farmers Federation, who talks to us about what they are doing to try encourage more farmers to start producing for export and not just home consumption. Views from the Top.
Good evening, viewers. My name is Dr. Dick Nwamanyaka Mganga. I'm the president of Uganda National Farmers Federation. And our main purpose, our main mandate is mobilize, organize, and empower smallholder farmers and speak for them, as well as partner for them. And then also look at the challenges and the opportunities associated with the farming sector. I'm pleased to be here to speak to you. Statistically, we actually have had a very positive agricultural growth as a sector, 3.8%. If you look the progressively in the last 2 years, that's above the population growth rate. And you know that agriculture sector is the driver of growth in the country. If it goes behind the schedules, then we have challenges in, especially in food security. We were negatively affected by COVID. Since March 2020, we have seen a slumber in the sector because of specifically of effects on our demand for our products, the farm products. You can just simply have a glimpse of what exactly happened. When schools got locked down, tourists are not coming into the country, and workshops were not being held, gatherings are not held, and ceremonies are not held. That is a loss of demand for our products, because whenever there is a gathering, whenever there is a school, there is consumption of farm products. So you had a cry from farmers all over the country, especially for those producing matoke. All the farm products had negative effects when it came to what we produced and the supply. The supply and demand was affected. But nonetheless, the sector grew at 3.8%. Absolutely. Our target is above 7%. And you know very well that the official statistics indicate 70, 80% of our citizens who are employed in the agriculture sector, depending on which statistics you read. But to me, I have a strong conviction that we provide, the sector provides the largest proportion of employment in the country. Above 85%. So what we have seen, the main challenge that has affected us basically is value addition. And then an opportunity emerged in a recent government program called National Development Plan 3. National Development Plan 3 prioritizes agro-industrialization. So as partners with government, we have embraced the National Development Plan 3 focus on agro-industrialization. So what we are doing is mobilizing, sensitizing to ensure that the farmers focus on the opportunities that are coming from NDP3, agro-industrialization. We thank the government for actually supporting through NADS, these equipment being given to the farmers, farmer groups. We support government for looking at a capitalization of UDB, Uganda Development Bank, and giving support to cooperatives. UDB is focusing on agro-processing. With agro-processing, with agro-industrialization, the key outcome will be value-added products. And value-added products is simple. Quality goes up, and the shelf life goes up, and then the price also goes up. When you value-add, you've entered into the industrial products. Industrial products usually have stable prices. So we get out of price volatility, which is characteristic of agriculture because of low level quality commodities. So what has been the role of the Federation in this? We mobilize, organize, sensitize and empower to grab these opportunities that the government is looking. We are actually strengthening our partnership with the Minister of Agriculture. The fact that the current minister is the former president of Uganda National Farmers Federation. So he understands the DNA. So we have strengthened our working relationship with him. We are working closely with OWC, Operation Wealth Creation and NADS, to ensure that these goals that have been put in NDP3 and the goal of agro-industrialization is accelerated among the farmers within the framework of parish development model. Region. The export market is a very complex one. At least from my experience, I have seen there are several factors to look at. Number one is quality. Once you have quality assurance, then you search for the next for the market outside. But there is also politics. Competition is very critical. Competition, exports are good for the exporter, but exports are bad for the importer. So they have domestic markets and domestic constituencies. For Kenya, we have seen it depends on us several times for grains. When it produces its own grain, then the imports from Uganda are bad. It locks the gates. But this is not, politics cannot only be the excuse that I'm going to give. I think it's incumbent on our country, it's incumbent on us to meet international standards as producers and become competitive. And as we speak right now, the new PSST, that is permanent secretary and secretary to the treasury, has injected in a momentum on what he calls the industrial policy. Industrial policy has an inward looking but also an outward looking strategy. An inward looking looks at how do we improve our competitiveness as producers and as exporters. And that's why agro-industrialization is very key in there. Agro-industrialization will drive quality up, not down. And once there is confidence on our quality, we will penetrate the international markets, both in the region and outside the region, the global markets. Now, there are opportunities that have emerged because of the African Continental Free Trade Area. So we are visualizing our competence within our competitiveness within East Africa, within COMESA, and the African continent. Later on, take charge of the markets that are provided by European Union, everything but arms, then the Americans and the Chinese.
All right, let's talk a bit about smallholder farmers, because I know for a fact that we have the bigger players, but these small guys make a bigger number. How are you bringing them on board to ensure that they look at quality if they are to export?
We have embarked, again, with the support from the ministry and support from OWC, we are embarked on mindset change. Farmers, unless consistently, smallholder farmers do not know that drying their maize, they know how to know that drying their maize on the floor affects the quality of the maize and therefore affects the opportunities for regional and international markets, including our own domestic markets. It doesn't mean aflatoxins should be consumed by locals. So this has been a knowledge gap to know that actually the practices at the farm affect the quality, affect the market, affect the price, affect the opportunities of a smallholder farm. So what we have been advocating and what we are going to be working with, because we have submitted our budget support request after identifying this challenge, we are going door to door, farmer to farmer sensitization on quality issues. We are, for instance, in grains, we are supporting the idea of micro warehouse receipt system, and whereby we are the managing agent of the warehouses at village level. And these would be farm stores owned by the farmers, but supervised by their organization, to ensure that whoever submits the output, the produce, it is of a certain quality in terms of moisture content, in terms of drying it, in terms of etc. All these practices that are expected at the farm. So we will be giving you a receipt as a confirmation of what you have kept with us. Once this maize or grain has reached at our store, we control the quality at this collective store.
All right, interesting conversation coming through from the Farmers Federation, and according to experts, Uganda needs to up its game in utilization of fertilizers. Kenya stands at about over 32 actually, and Tanzania is at 29, Rwanda is at 6 per hectare, Uganda is at 1.5 per hectare. That is way below. It's something we need to improve to ensure that we help our farmers to increase on production. Of course, we know that it comes with a cost, but these are some of the bottlenecks that were being addressed. What is the way forward to help farmers access what they can afford to improve on their production? You're watching The Business Show with me, Simon Towner. Have a quick break on the program. In the meantime, feel free to get in touch with us. Tell us where you're watching from or what you're doing for your Easter holiday that is coming through very soon. I'll see you after the break.